If you've been trying to live stream with the DJi Action 4 to a platform like Kick, Twitch or YouTube, then this is the video for you. The method I'll be sharing with you works for any platform. I have to read my script for this one. I attempted several tests during a recent live stream, opting for one phone setup to keep things simple. The Action 4, my S23 Ultra, and the Mimo app, which is available for Android and iOS. The S23 has a mobile hotspot feature which the Action 4 can connect to, but check with your mobile provider to see if this is available. Once I was able to live stream, I'd swipe out of the Mimo app as it can run in the background, then over to the Kick app or IRL link app to check the stream and read live chat. Also during the test stream, I had my iPhone streaming a POV of what I was doing. I'm planning to use my home PC setup for a later test with the Action 4, so I had to stream direct to Twitch using HD64 and RTMP with no bonding, meaning this other stream was vulnerable to dropouts. I fully expected it to be broken up into multiple videos, but you'll be surprised how well it did. Okay, here's the tests I performed in order. The first stream was direct to Kick. The second stream was direct to Restream in order to multi-stream to Kick and YouTube. Remember, the iPhone was already streaming to Twitch, so I couldn't multi-stream to all three without ending the first one. The third stream was relayed through an RTMP endpoint to my computer at home. All these services provide a stream URL and stream key you can use for your mobile app. Here's the results. The first stream wouldn't work. Maybe it's because the Mimo app doesn't support RTMPS, which is what Kick uses. For the second stream, the audio was okay to Kick. Welcome everyone, welcome to this bonus live stream. But for YouTube, welcome everyone, welcome to this bonus live stream. I think this might have to do with multi-streaming with an action camera and an external mic. And the third stream was the only one that worked without any flaws. YouTube, Twitch, and Kick. Hi everyone. Say hello to each other, wave. Go give us a follow and all the things. During this test, the iPhone stream to Twitch worked for over 4 hours. No disconnects, no audio issues, which is why I'm a big advocate for phone streaming. Just saying. Anyway, here's what you'll need. First, you'll need an RTMP endpoint from IRL Hosting. Sign up or log into your account. I've already done that. I'm going to just go over to this tab. Scroll down and copy the OBS Ingest. Then open OBS, add a new scene if necessary. I've got one called SceneCam1 and a media source called SourceCam1. To add a media source, you can either right click add and then find media source from the list. Alternatively, there's this plus button and then find media source. So I've already done that and renamed it to SourceCam1. Now double click on it to bring up the properties. Firstly, we're going to uncheck local file. Then we're going to change the network buffering from 2 to 1. For input, we're going to paste the OBS ingest URL from IRL Hosting. And for input format, we're going to type RTMP. For reconnect delay, we're going to change that from 10 to 5. And scroll down a little. For close file when inactive, we're going to check or tick to enable it. When you're done, click OK. Going to go back to IRL Hosting and copy the RTMP URL for the phone. Select the text and then copy, and then we'll bring up the phone. For the phone, we're going to enable hotspot mode. I'm going to go into the settings, connections, mobile hotspot and tethering. Mobile hotspot, we're going to enable that. Go into mobile hotspot, and then for this setting, which is for the band, we want 5 GHz preferred. Take a note of your network name and password. You can change the band here. Save if you need to, otherwise we can cancel. Everything looks good there. You can open up the Mimo app. You want to grab your Action 4. Make sure that's powered on. Scroll to the bottom. Tap on this camera icon. It's looking good so far. Connect. Once you're connected, you can swipe over to live stream. Tap on RTMP, start live stream settings. Okay, for select network, it's already done that for us. What you would normally do, there's a button to connect manually, get enter in your Wi-Fi name, in which case we've noted those down from the hotspot settings. So we're already connected, just gonna close out of that. For enter RTMP URL, that's where you'll paste the details from IRL Hosting, and that is the RTMP URL. So we're just gonna paste that in. For the other settings, I'm going to use 1080p, for stream quality HD, And for EIS, electronic image stabilization, I usually go with either Walk Steady or Horizon Balancing. Tap on the Start Live Stream button when you're ready to go live. So let's try that now. Things looking good here. And with the broadcast from the Action 4 and OBS, I'd use Restream to multi-stream to Kick, Twitch, or YouTube. And I'd control OBS, like when to start and stop streaming, change scenes and more with StreamerBot using Twitch chat commands. There's lots of other options I've talked about on my channel, links in the description. For disconnect protection, add an image or muted video clip below the media source in OBS. Or I found LOOPY SRT works with this kind of setup if it's the primary live or cam1c in the config file. For more info on how to set up LOOPY SRT for your live or cam1 scene, check out this video right over here. For more info on how to set up LOOPY, the third stream was relayed through an RTMP